Charlas de la noche. Palabras con imagen. El análisis de los acontecimientos que influyen en nuestra vida con el periodista Francisco Durán Rosillo.
Frank Durán Rosillo te saluda y los saluda a todos ustedes, su amiga María Celeste Raraz, para invitarlos a que se suscriban a mi canal de YouTube, María Celeste Raraz, tal como mi nombre, donde les informo todas las semanas sobre entrevistas que tienen un tema que ayuda a mejorarnos como personas y de paso son interesantes. Las pueden encontrar en mi canal de YouTube, así que los espero. Y se suscriben gratis.
A Joe Biden ya no le queda otra. El político con mayor permanencia en puestos del Senado principalmente, pues ya no le queda de otra más que tratar de cerrar con broche de oro su administración débil como presidente. ¿Y qué sucede? Al igual que George Bush padre, recuerden que, él prometió que no se iban a subir los impuestos y por eso también solo gobernó un cuatrienio. Pero para tener la permanencia y no pasar al anonimato de los presidentes intrascendentes, recuerden que hizo pues detalles como la tormenta del desierto y detener a Manuel Noriega. Bueno, Joe Biden está siguiendo el mismo camino. Ya sus asesores le dicen: presidente Biden ya dimitió, haga algo importante para que realmente consolide al Partido Demócrata, consolide al Partido Demócrata con detalles que realmente puedan convencer a sus opositores, porque Donald Trump sigue muy fuerte. ¿Y cuál fue la decisión? Empezar la cacería de narcos. Y como lo van a ver en la historia, el Mayo Zambada y un hijo del Chapo Guzmán fueron detenidos en un aeropuerto del Paso, Texas, en un avión privado bimotor, por la DEA y varias autoridades, y llevados a una corte federal. Van a ver la historia, pero ahí no termina. Ya el equipo Biden, con el Departamento de Justicia, ya la decisión está tomada. Los planes que Alm Ingram, la directora de la DEA, tenía encarpetados, porque realmente solo estaba la investigación, los datos de inteligencia, pero no se ponía a funcionar, no soltaban las bombas nucleares del Departamento de Justicia y del Tesoro. Bueno, pues ahora sí, ya van y con todo, al grado tal de que López Obrador va a tener momentos bastante álgidos y mucha gente espera que varios de los que le rodean sean detenidos, incluidos algunos de sus hijos. Vamos a ver la historia. Está en toda la prensa norteamericana. Nos vemos y nos escuchamos mañana. Gracias.
The U.S. Justice Department says it has arrested two leaders of the notorious Sinaloa cartel in Texas. Ismael Zambada, nicknamed El Mayo, ran the powerful cartel for decades alongside its notorious leader Joaquin El Chapo Guzman. The U.S. government had offered a reward of $15 million for his arrest. Guzman's son, Joaquin Guzman Lopez, was also taken into custody. U.S. officials say they were arrested after landing in a private plane and will face charges related to running the criminal network and manufacturing and trafficking fentanyl throughout the U.S. Well, for more on this, I'm joined now by Professor Juan Carlos Montero from the Monterrey Institute of Technology. Professor Montero, welcome.
Thank you very much.
Just how significant are these arrests?
Well, these arrests are very important because the cartel of Sinaloa is the main enemy from the United States because of the smuggling of fentanyl in the country. And because of the electoral campaign right now, it's going to be a big issue, the detention, especially from El Mayo Zambada. It's also important to mention the role of Ovidio Guzman, who was detained some months ago. And some reports are saying that he was released some days ago. And then the structure of the cartel of Sinaloa is going to move in the next days.
Yeah, I want to talk to you about how this will impact on that cartel and other smaller ones, but just how big an operation was it to getting these men into custody, to detaining these men?
It implied an important negotiation from the DEA and the Chapitos especially, because the Chapitos and El Mayo Zambada have serious issues in disputing the leadership of Cartel de Sinaloa. So we can hypothesize that they negotiated with the DEA, because this wasn't an operation from the DEA. It looks like they turned themselves into custody with for the DEA. We can mention also that perhaps it was treason from the Chapitos to El Mayo, but at the end it was they are turning themselves in, and it wasn't a detention from the DEA in Mexico or in the United States.
Okay, can you tell us a little bit more in depth about the Sinaloa cartel? We know that they were responsible for the manufacturing and trafficking of fentanyl, as you just mentioned, but what do they do at a more granular level, and how do they operate?
Well, they traffic fentanyl, and they receive fentanyl from different ports, especially in Manzanillo and Guaymas in Sonora, and they both smuggle fentanyl and also different methamphetamines produced in Mexico in different states, from Michoacán, Jalisco, Colima, Sinaloa, Sonora, all the Pacific coast of Mexico, and they smuggle the fentanyl and methamphetamines to the United States, especially from the borders of Sonora and Chihuahua. And they are disputing right now the north border of Tamaulipas with the Cartel of Noreste and Cartel del Golfo. So they are the main criminal organization, and they operate in this way. They receive fentanyl from China in the ports of Guaymas and Manzanillo, and they smuggled by land from the different borders in Sonora and Chihuahua.
So today's developments, how do you see this impacting the manufacture, the illegal manufacture and distribution of fentanyl in the United and methamphetamines in the United States?
That's right, especially fentanyl. That's the enemy of the United States, and the main provider of fentanyl to the United States is the Cartel of Sinaloa.
Yeah, so are these two arrests today going to impact on the distribution and manufacture of those illegal goods into the United States?
Not much. It's an important strike against the organization. It's going to call our attention. We're going to talk a lot about this, but the structure is not going to be modified very much. The Chapitos are keeping the control of the cartel, and they are going to keep it clearly undisputed, it because the Mayo Zambada is no longer there. So they are going to fight with Cartel Jalisco Nueva Generación, and they are going to keep fighting with other cartels in the south of Mexico, but the structure of Cartel de Sinaloa is going to remain untouched.
Okay, all right, so it won't then leave a vacuum in the distribution of these illegal drugs for smaller cartels, say, to fight it out, to fill a void?
No, it won't. Perhaps we're going to see some instability in the state of Sonora, perhaps with certain groups against the Chapitos, but the Chapitos remain in control, and now they are undisputed. So we're not going to see this vacuum.
So if you're essentially cutting off the head of a cartel, with, you know, El Chapo was incarcerated, I think, in 2017, a life sentence. Now we've had these other two high-profile arrests. If you're cutting off the head, which is essentially what this sounds like it is, but it's still maintaining to have its presence, what do authorities need to do to impact and to stop the illegal trade of fentanyl and methamphetamine coming from the South into the United States of America?
they need to prosecute the money. And the thing is that the Mexican government is not showing that they are going after the money. The United States are, and they are imposing several sanctions to different companies associated with different cartels, but Mexican government is not. And I think that it's that should be the strategy. They should be targeting the money and not targeting people. Because as we said, the leadership is not going to be contested. We're not going to see problems in the structure of cartel de Sinaloa. But if the Mexican government actually cut the economy, the funds of the organizations, not just the Sinaloa cartel, but any other organization, then we would see important strikes against the organizations. The money is the key.
Very interesting indeed. Professor Juan Carlos Montero, many thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much.
Seguiremos informando tan pronto tengamos más datos, pero lo que está seguro es que Joe Biden quiere un trofeo más para su administración y van a ser las cabezas del gobierno mexicano que están protegiendo a todos estos narcos. Se ve que fue una detención negociada, pero platicando con alguien de la DEA, la situación no se queda allí. Los americanos quieren ir por más porque esto representaría la permanencia del Partido Demócrata en la Casa Blanca. Buenas noches, buenos días, nos vemos y nos escuchamos mañana. Hasta entonces.
Frank Durán Rosillo te saluda y los saluda a todos ustedes, su amiga María Celeste Raraz, para invitarlos a que se suscriban a mi canal de YouTube, María Celeste Raraz, tal como mi nombre, donde les informo todas las semanas sobre entrevistas que tienen un tema que ayuda a mejorarnos como personas y de paso son interesantes. Las pueden encontrar en mi canal de YouTube, así que los espero. Y se suscriben gratis.
Escuchaste el análisis de la noticia, transparente como el agua, con el periodista Francisco Durán Rosillo.